This is such a weird game mechanic. I don't know why anyone would... And the graphics are bizarre. This is all so strange. Okay, so it did thought I had a sticky one. So I was pressing it too fast. Windows is weird for that. But now it's not... Okay. What is happening? How do I... This is so difficult. Because I don't have big fingers. I have small hands. It's difficult for my pinky to hit the shift key. I am not a keyboard gamer. I am very much a controller gamer. Oh lord. What is happening? I cannot get the timing of this. Oh my lord. Make it stop. Make it end. Please just let me die. Thank you. Oh my god. I think that's the worst fucking thing I've ever played in my life.
There are two kinds of people in this world. Those who are born with worth, and everybody else.
I mean, that's a way of looking at it, sure.
No matter how hard a lowly human tries, they will never be the same as someone who was born worthy. They say that
this is a perspective to have.
But that's a complete lie. The world is not that accommodating. No matter how hard a small dog tries, it will never become a large dog.
Okay, that...
No matter how much a penguin tries, there's no way it will ever soar through the sky. Which means, unworthy humans will never become worthy, no matter what they do.
Oh god. This is such a dangerous perspective to have, but I... The reality is that there's people who do think this way, and, yeah, like, that is a thing.
People with talent don't become talented. They're just born with their abilities right from the start.
No.
That's right.
You can, like, get skill.
Just like you guys. That's why I have so much respect for you all.
Oh my god.
Just so you know, what I feel is different from admiration.
I mean, yeah, I just don't know if it's envy, jealousy, or any, like, something like that, or, like, something else entirely, like, I don't get it with him, I really don't.
Admiration is wishing you could be like the object of your admiration, but what I feel is not so self-serving, how should I put it? What I feel is more pure. More like a selfless love that wants nothing in return.
Are you sure about that, though?
So, I want you guys to believe me when I say, I don't mind if you kill me. But if that happens,
oh, Jesus.
I want you to let me help.
Oh, God.
I don't care if the killer survives, or if everyone but the killer survives. I just want both sides to do their very best.
This is a goddamn perspective to have, like, what? Why does he want both sides? I don't understand. He's like this weird gray area in the Danganronpa, universe, because everything is very extreme in the in that universe, I find, and he's... what you would be the extreme neutral? Almost, except not neutral, because he wants both sides to do their very best. I don't know.
I want to see with my own two eyes the absolute hope that lies ahead. Yep, I'm really lucky. Someone as insignificant as me will be there when hope and despair collide and unleash their energy.
I'm sure,
so please,
yeah.
Let me
You're definitely
you.
Very in the middle of things, both in the series in general, more especially with, like, this game and Ultimate Despair Girls. V3 was, like, interesting and all, but it was a lot of fun with the first two games more so because, well, the first two games and then Ultra Despair Girls because, they were really building like a solid universe and what existed in it, and then V3 just kind of came out of left field in comparison to that, plot-wise, and how, and like, it, as far as I'm aware, it doesn't necessarily fit as easily in the universe that was being built, in the world building that was going on with Danganronpa initially. I don't know if that makes sense to anyone else, but that's kind of, because like, I still liked it, don't get me wrong, but I don't know. Interesting.
If you're planning to kill me, I would be honored to help you carry out your plan. I want you to use me as a stepping stone so everyone can shine. I want you to kill me in a way that befits.
Oh, shut up! Someone got punched in the face. And for good reason. See in punishment, sin in coconuts. Okay, but like, that was so much, just right off the fucking get. My lord. Well, he was a crazy guy who killed someone. He totally deserved to die.
Hey.
I understand how you feel, but you're going too far.
That's weird.
Huh? Is it alright to defend a killer? Are you trying to justify murder?
No.
No, that was not my intention, but...
Hey!
Then you've gotta hate him more than ever. You've gotta hate him from the bottom of your heart. He's a stupid piece of trash bastard who committed the lowest crime possible. He deserved to get killed. In fact, I'm rather relieved he was executed. If I could have, I would have totally spat on him too.
Jeez!
Hey, what gives? Does a pea brain like you have something to complain about?
It's not like that.
Well, it's not about that, but...
It smells.
Something smells, don't you think?
Huh?
Again?
It can't be!
Don't tell me. It better not be another dead body. Nah, it's not the smell of blood this time. It just smells really bad. It smells bad. It's kind of like how a bar or nightclub smells after closing time, you see.
Hey!
I don't know those smells. You must have had a pretty rough life.
Now that you mention it.
Now that you mention it, I do smell something. It's like a sewer or rotting garbage.
I got it!
I know what it is. Nekomaru's breath probably stinks. You've got me there. She didn't say anything remotely funny just now. Yeah, I definitely haven't gotten any worse. So, I'm happy about that. No, it's not Nekomaru. The smell is coming from... you, Hyoko.
Hmm?
Huh?
Whoa!
Whoa, it's true! Hyoko, you reek!
What did you do to me?
A rotten smell stings my eyes, as if a demonic eclipse is about to commence. Oh, she cannot take anything. Like, and yet she dishes out the worst shit.
Oh my my!
Oh, she's crying.
Hey!
I've said it before, but you guys are really insensitive.
That was close.
Ah, no, it actually doesn't smell that bad. I mean, as long as I breathe with my mouth.
Like,
are you even taking baths? Oh, God. No. You haven't bathed? I can't help it. I can't tie my kimono sash by myself.
Hey.
Hey, Hyoko. You don't have to cry so much. I'll tie your sash for you, okay? Really? I can only tie a simple knot, but if that's okay with you, I can teach you.
Yay!
I guess that completely fixed that. I love you, Mahiru. I'll give you a kiss. Hey, Hyoko, you don't have to hug me.
It appears you cannot escape.
Yeah, she appears to have taken a liking to you. Welcome to the world of girl love. It's slippery when wet. Jesus Christ, that was not what I was expecting from Ibuki. Okay. The air's suddenly not so tense anymore. Well, I guess it's better than being down forever. If I was all by myself, I probably wouldn't have been able to put my feelings aside and move on like this. I guess I have these guys to thank.
What's the matter?
What's up? Did someone get kidnapped or something?
You came at just the right time.
Mm-hmm. At the right time?
No, it's nothing.
I don't really get it, but... you must have yearned for me! Your outlook on life has changed due to my cuteness, so your body can't stand to live without me, huh? I can't help myself, you know. My body reacts to Monokuma on its own.
No.
Something like that.
Stupid.
Who cares about that? Just hurry up and tell us why you're here.
Actually,
to be honest, I'm searching too. My valued servant has disappeared. Servant?
What the hell?
You know, my Mono Beasts. One of them just disappeared. Huh? One of the Mono Beasts disappeared? Maybe I cut back on the cost of their food too much? Perhaps they're boycotting me? But that guy is the weakest of the League of Four. How shameful for a Mono Beast to lose to a mere human. That's what you want to say, right? Though this is merely the prelude, the climax will occur soon after. Now then, let me hear your scream! I shall make such sweet music for you. Monokuma's like, bitch!
Yeah, yeah.
Gundam, you should stop playing with that stuffed animal. I'm still being called a stuffed animal. Oh well, it looks like you guys don't know anything about my Mono Beast either. Then it's a waste of time for me to worry about it. I don't want to go bald from worrying too much. A wise pet bot once said, our eyes are on the front so we can keep moving forward. As Monokuma said those familiar sounding words to us, once again, he disappeared. Were you in the middle of something? If so, I can just come back later. Then leave.
Yeah.
Yeah, at least ask me to leave kindly.
Hey.
Before you leave, I want to ask you something. Did you have anything to do with the disappearing Mono Beast?
Yeah.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Ta-da! I'm the one who defeated that Mono Beast. You did?
You serious?
Defeating a monster like that? How the hell did someone like you pull that off? I'll talk about that in more detail in a different mode. Anyway, I've released the bridge gate for you all.
Hey.
If the gate is open, that means we can go to the new island across the bridge, right? Is that true?
Ahem,
that's totally right. Now that you all can go to more areas, let's all get along and live a fun life together, for sure this time.
Love.
Living together on this island isn't what's important. We need to find a way to escape. Of course, escaping from this island is our main goal.
Huh?
Nobody wants to live in a swashbuckling Hollywood-type action film. I want to live a life where I can be more average. A life where nothing happens. That's better for me.
Alright,
if you find anything that can be salvaged for boat parts, let me know immediately.
It seems that everyone's united on a path that's different from what I had planned.
Now then, let's
disperse. The time has come to release the cursed seal.
All right,
let's find a way to leave this island.
That is impossible. Leaving the island is no longer possible.
No longer possible? Hey, what is that?
Hey,
Hajime, just leave that thing alone already. After all, she's the same as Monokuma. It's better if you don't get that close to her. You're right. It seems everyone's attention has shifted toward exploring the new island. Expecting to find something that'll help us escape the situation, everyone filed out of the restaurant. So I glanced over to the beach where Ibuki was pointing her finger. Oh, and it's just them too.
Your speed is adequate, but it's still not enough. Each blow you land is too soft.
What the heck is this?
You're not using your muscles properly. Your athletic body is going to waste.
Shut up! All I gotta do is win.
What was that? You're gonna win? Against me? That's quite absurd!
I feel like they're just training.
Ah! Huh?
Had enough? Have you learned your lesson?
We're done.
He's
for
done it! Nekomaru Nidai's ultimate move, Super Body Blow! That's instant death. If she's lucky, she'll live another 5 minutes at best.
Sheesh.
Akane, at your current power level, you cannot even defeat a mere team manager. What are you saying? Why are you guys fighting?
Huh?
This isn't a fight. It's a one-sided beatdown. That's even worse. The rules for the school trip clearly state excessive violence is prohibited.
Training!
What violence? This is not a real fight. We're training. But it looked like a real fight.
Huh?
I'm just a team manager. There's no way I'd be able to fight for real. We both agreed to this training session. I'm not
I'm not violating any rules at all. Even so, why the sudden interest in training? If I gotta admit it...
What the?
Ah, she's alive.
Fool.
She's not a weakling who'd get killed by a weak blow like that. He looked pretty strong, so I couldn't help but get excited. I thought sparring would help me burn off some of this energy, but I lost. More importantly, there's a lot of strong dudes in this world, huh?
Aww.
What a bunch of battle-loving troublemakers.
I see.
Akane, it seems you're the type who learns through actions rather than words. So I shall give you just one piece of advice. How you use your body and muscles, your positioning and your timing, it's all half-assed. If you are not utilizing your ultimate gymnast talent well at all...
Oh,
you're not utilizing your ultimate gymnast... Fuck. Whatever. Basics. Make sure you understand the basics. You'll always be second rate if you just rely on instinct.
You.
Damn it. Shut up.
Then.
If you understand what I just said, come see me. When that time comes, I'll fight you once again.
Don't forget.
Hey, you better not forget what you just said. My desire to win is pretty crazy.
I'll show you my serious
side. I won't give up
side.
Until I beat you. With wobbling steps, Akane left the beach.
However,
if she fought that fiercely with just her own style, how ominous. My hands are still numb.
That girl,
she's probably gonna
get even stronger.
Wait, why'd they voice that one and not anything else? Okay.
Yeah, you're probably right.
What kind of conversation is this?
You can't!
Whoa, it's here! Hey. Why not? Are you trying to interfere with my love affair with Miss Sonya?
I won't forgive you!
Like how the first game's manga adaptation was fully complete while the second one is unfinished. Is it really? They should really finish it if they can. Changing in the beach house is prohibited. It would be bad if shameful peeking occurred. Oh, so you mean changing gear isn't allowed, not going to see the beach itself. Then I'll just have to come here after changing. I'm never gonna give her up. You might let her down, though.
Got it?
Anyway, breaking the rules is not allowed. Also, playing is fine, but please focus on your studies, too.
You guys?
Where? Where's the rule breaker? I'll beat the crap out of them. No questions asked!
Oh, okay, sure. Yeah, he's here.
You. What are you holding?
Oh, never mind. It's Hajime. You. What are you holding?
A machine gun, obviously. Rule breakers will be shot to death. That's just common sense.
It's common sense where? It's not like we're under a military dictatorship.
I want to shoot something. I know I'm not allowed to, but I really, really want to shoot something right now.
Control yourself.
Hold it.
I have iron willpower, so I'll endure it, no matter the cost. Until this day someone breaks...
Ouch.
I have the iron willpower, so I'll endure it, no matter the cost. Until the day someone breaks the rules.
As you can see, it's very dangerous, so please refrain from changing at the beach house. Wow, that was totally bizarre. Man, they're annoying. Yeah, I feel very tired all of a sudden. Yeah, I did. It was fucking great. What are you reading? Are those political books or maybe some kind of philosophy? The newest issue of Occult Magazine! It breaks the lid off underground mysteries and the wonders of the world. That's quite a surprise.
You are wrong.
It is not like I read it often. I'm just reading it because it has a special article about serial killers. That's not a good excuse at all.
However,
it seems this writer has very good taste. I mean, even Genocide Jack is mentioned in the article. Aha! I love how it's connecting the other things. The Genocide Jack or whatever. I feel like I've heard about her before.
Most tight.
Genocide Jack is an alleged Japanese serial killer who has a reputation even among casual internet users. She is very popular among youths and is known for writing messages in blood at the scene of the crime.
Wow!
Apparently, she is a high school or middle school student who wears a sailor uniform. Be careful, Hajime! How do you know how many high school and middle school girls wear sailor uniforms? Do you know how many high school and middle school girls wear sailor uniforms these days?
Yeah.
Ah, this one is a particular favorite of mine. Sparkling Justice is a regular subject of these kinds of exclusive articles. I shall explain it to you, just in case. Sparkling Justice is a serial killer who calls themselves the Ally of Justice. Wearing a wide variety of hero masks, Sparkling Justice is a delightful serial killer who only kills criminals.
Okay. This is a really weird rabbit hole that she is taking us down. Like, don't get me wrong, I like the true crime as much as the next person, but I'm not like this. That's for sure. Sonia, calm down.
Amazing!
Thanks to the masks Sparkling Justice wears, nobody knows their real age or gender. After all, it is essential that serial killers be mysterious. What an expert, yes.
Hey, you two. I've been listening in for a while now, but why are you talking about mirror murderers with such enthusiasm? I haven't done any talking.
Please wait!
Please hold on. It is a mistake to refer to these people as mere murderers.
See?
Coming in contact with a value system that differs from your own is a very important matter. Serial killers, their value system is very different than the norm. What a marvelous existence!
Okay, I mean, I understand why you would be intrigued, because I am also intrigued, but my enthusiasm with the intrigue is very differently presenting than yours. I am totes intrigued! Is this kind of like a young lady crushing on a total bad boy type of situation? Regardless, it's clearly different from a princess who's obsessed with serial killers. Yeah, that's different, alright.
Surprise!
I am a little surprised. I never expected to find such a splendid facility. It rivals even my homeland's national library. But isn't it strange? I mean, does a resort really need a library like this?
I am concerned.
That is very true, and just as expected, nobody is here either. You're right. The fact that we're the only humans around here is even more strange. Ta-da! Monami is here! I'm reading a book! Since you've come in here, would you like me to explain this library to you? I see. It's clear from your surface I'm a nuisance. Since I was more energetic than usual, I feel even emptier now. And what about your explanation?
Got it?
Well, you're absolute...
Oop.
Well, you're all basically students, right? I was thinking you needed a place where you can do homework.
Ta-da!
So, I have prepared this library.
Prepared? You?
Everyone can get along and study together. It's a student's duty to study.
Don't act like a teacher.
Hey!
I am a teacher.
You're even more confusing than Monokuma. So what's your real identity? What's your purpose?
Real identity? Now that's a silly. Now that's silly. Goodbye. Running away as soon as things get inconvenient. That's even more suspicious.
However,
I cannot believe that she is the one who prepared this grand facility. Yeah, she's probably lying.
I see.
According to this island's guidebook, many of their guests are wealthy and stay for weeks at a time.
Which means?
These are all probably things that they donated. Hold on, did you just say this island's guidebook? I found it in this library. Would you like to take a look? Oh, look at that. What language is this? I have no clue.
Then
I shall read it on your behalf. You can read it, Sonia? I am fluent in 30 different languages. It is a requirement for members of the royal family. 30 languages? Does the royal family have a limit? Jabberwock Island is a small island in the Pacific Ocean known for being a paradise of eternal summer. That is what it says. It is exactly what Byakuya told us before. Jabberwock Island consists of a small central island surrounded by 5 other islands. The outer islands were developed as resorts, while the central island houses a large administrative building. Huh?
It is strange,
That is strange. I mean, the central island of Jabberwock Island... There was no sign of any buildings at all. The only things there were Monokuma Rock and the park.
yeah. But, this game is originally made in Japanese, so what I find that would be interesting is if they had the English pictures, but it was, the rest of the game would be in Japanese, because then that would make sense, because not every single Japanese person knows English, but usually,
At least if you're in a big city, they do know English, and that's because I think it's a requirement, or at least very heavily suggested. It says that there is a bronze statue in the lobby of that building which symbolizes the island. Huh? Isn't that... Are you talking about that bronze statue that turned into the Mona Beasts? But that statue is in the middle of a park, not in the lobby of some building.
Please wait!
That is not all. There is another description that strikes me as strange. According to this guidebook, the only way to travel between the five islands is by boat. Huh? While some people wanted bridges, critics worried about their effect on the environment, so none were built. What does that mean? Then what are we using to move between islands? There's a possibility that this place is an artificial island like Palm Jumeirah, artificial island.
Well,
Palm Jumeirah is a huge artificial island and tourist site located in the Persian Gulf. Similarly, this island might be an artificial island designed to look like Jabberwock Island.
It cannot be.
That especially might be why we are the only ones on this island.
Just kidding.
Well, something like that would be impossible anyway. No island of this size could be completely artificial. This guidebook must be old, too. It contradicts everything about the island's current situation.
Well done!
Oh, yeah, it is kind of funny.
My, you're very intuitive to assume this is an artificial island.
Now you're here?
Hey! However, those guys are the only ones who could do something on such a massive scale.
Those guys?
The hint is, you know, the enormous organization you guys were talking about before. It's true that those guys totally deserve to be called a horrible group of people.
Who are you talking about?
Oops, that was a slip of the tongue. I should excuse myself before it leaks onto the internet.
Hey, hold on a second. But before my voice could reach him, Monokuma disappeared as well.
It cannot be.
Could it be this island is completely artificial? There's no way that's true. There's no way that guidebook. It's probably just old.
You are right.
That's right. That's obviously what it is. He's just saying strange things just to confuse us. Damn it. There's no way I'll fall for that.
Hajime.
Oh, it's you, Chiaki. What happened?
Well?
I'm letting everyone else know too, but can you come to the ancient ruins on this island right away? You can, right? Right away, okay? Hurry up! Based on her pushy tone, she might have found some kind of clue. Then I guess I should head over to the ancient ruins. Yeah? What about the door? It's hard to make out from all the dust, but this is the door you mean, right?
That's right.
Yeah, it looks like that's the door to the ruin.
Hey!
So what's wrong with this door? Can you go inside? Before we attempt to go inside, let's try brushing off some of this dust and clearing some of these root things off the door. If you do, I'm pretty sure you'll understand what I mean by unnatural.
For now.
I don't really understand, but I guess we should try and do what she says. You're right. Just as Chiaki said, we brushed off the dust and cleared the roots that were stuck to the door. And then... Well then! What is this door? It doesn't feel like it belongs in an ancient ruin.
What's going on?
It's like a door from a sci-fi movie, don't you think? It definitely doesn't fit with an ancient ruin. And what is this symbol on the door? It looks like it's Japanese.
Oh!
Ah, you're totally right. I'm sorry if it's just my misunderstanding. To me, it looks like it says Mirai, or future. Future.
Bastard!
It's probably talking about Future Foundation in this particular sense. Because we founded Future Foundation just before, or just after, leaving Hope's Peak Academy. And this was the door that we would have exited out of. Hey, who cares about a symbol on the door? More importantly, how do you open it? What's inside?
Hey!
It looks like there's a liquid crystal display next to the door. Could the two be related?
Hey.
Oh, right. That must be the key to open the door. It's probably set to open when you type the password.
Yes!
Acting all high and mighty, so what's next? It's obviously impossible to put in the password without any hints. Are you saying a normal person can't open it, but a Yakuza can? That's hilarious.
Shut up!
Shut up! If we just type whatever, we might get it right.
Hold it!
Oh, I think we should wait. Doesn't that seem dangerous?
Hmm?
What do you mean dangerous? Because that thing next to the panel, doesn't it look like a gun? In fact, that's totally a gun.
Gun?
Huh? That's a gun?
If it is, it's probably very dangerous. It's possible you might get shot if you mess up the password, right?
Damn it. It can't be helped. Looks like it's better if we don't mess with it for now.
He's totally freaked out.
Shut the hell up!
Shut the hell up! You do it then. But still, a building that looks like an ancient ruin with a door that looks like it's from a sci-fi film? It's definitely unnatural. This is probably an important place. Important place, huh? The problem is, how is it important? You're both quiet.
I'll beat you up!
You guys know about this building too, right? Just be honest with us.
I'm sorry!
I have no idea at all.
I don't know either.
Now, everyone should focus on gathering the hope fragments.
I won't be fooled.
Hey, there's no way you guys don't know. Don't just show up and tell some lousy lies. You guys are probably the ones who covered that door with dust, right? Just as I thought. You guys are hiding it on purpose, right?
Hey!
Hey, don't talk like we're equals, you trashy bitch!
I'm sorry!
Say you're sorry, bitch!
Why?
I just said it! I just said I'm sorry! Is it possible that there is a connection between this door and the reason this island is uninhabited? For example, this place might be a shelter, and there might be natives inside.
Hey!
Is something happening that would make them hide in a shelter? If so, we're all screwed.
You're getting all riled up!
Several possibilities cross my mind. But it looks like there's no way to confirm it yet. That door is really sturdy. But not in a material sense. More essential than that.
Huh?
What are you saying?
Hey!
For instance, even though Monami and I can come and go as we please, we can't enter what's beyond that door.
Huh? You can't go inside too? Does that mean you're the same as me and...
Your tongue in your mouth!
Bye-bye.
My body can't handle a supersonic meteor rush like that.
Well, she got beaten up again. Oh, I totally missed some chat stuff. What's going on? We scavenged to get materials around the island to make explosives. That doesn't necessarily guarantee it opening the door. Or having us live after we break open the door. It will go down like a bank vault. I don't know about that.
There, now that I've shut up my sister with a fantastic Pegasus meteor fist. This is the mystery of Jabberwock Island. A mystery that even Monami and I can't solve. That's why I have high expectations for you guys. One day you'll be able to solve that mystery.
That seems easy enough. All we gotta do is remember what that black and white Tanuki said before.
Hey, why are there 16 of you? If a total of 15 students from Hope's Peak Academy were arranged to come to this island...
I got it!
That's right! There's probably a traitor I don't even know about hiding among the group! Just kidding!
I know!
There's a traitor among us. That's what that ugly Tanuki said before.
Fine.
Calling me an ugly and a Tanuki. Those kinds of silly names don't depress me in the slightest.
Hello!
He's totally depressed. If there's a traitor, they probably know how to open the door, right? And there's probably boats or a way to contact the outside world beyond that door. Or maybe whoever's controlling Monokuma and Monami is hiding there.
What?
But do you really think there's a traitor among us?
No shit!
Of course there is! Who the hell is it? Hurry up and confess!
Yes!
There isn't! There's no traitor anywhere!
Hey, bastard!
Monokuma, what about you? You're the one who mentioned it. That's so funny.
Hey!
Oh, Jess! Have you guys ever heard of an organization called World Ender?
World Ender? I'm the one asking you a question. Don't just change the subject.
Come on!
I understand why you'd want to just ignore it. World Ender is such an embarrassing name. So embarrassing that only middle school students... No, wait. Elementary school students would come up with it. But the name is unavoidable because that organization actually exists.
So what is this organization?
It's literally what it says. Those guys ended the world! ended the world?
Hey,
That's not an overstatement or a metaphor, you know. Those guys really did end the world. So don't you think it's appropriate to call them World Ender?
So basically...
So, you mean they're a terrorist organization?
Terrorist, huh? That might be accurate. But only losers are terrorists if they... But only losers are terrorists. If they manage to win, they become heroes.
Oh, this is starting to reference Ultimate Despair Girls 2. Or Ultimate Despair Girls. I don't know if a second one ever was released. I really need to look into that.
In that sense, they're more like heroes. They're the heroes who ended the world.
What's going on?
So what? Don't say things that don't make sense. Don't tell me you're gonna say this organization is the one putting us through all this crap. World Ender. Are you saying that you and Monami are also members of that organization?
Who knows?
Who knows? The only thing I can tell you is, the organization that the traitor is working for, the ones who brought you to this island, World Ender is behind it all!
Are you kidding me?
Why are we being targeted by a horrifying organization like that?
Don't panic.
It's just another made-up story to trick us, like when he said we lost our school memories. I can't suspend my disbelief for something as ridiculous as World Ender. There's no way that organization or the traitor exists.
Stay back.
Monokuma, I shall listen to you spout nonsense all you want while I puff cigar smoke at your lifeless body.
My. I was kind enough to keep you guys informed. Are you calling me a liar?
What the hell?
If you keep acting like that, I'll do this and that to your various body parts.
Silence!
Anyway, I'm telling the truth. The World Ender organization is the final boss of this island. Plus, one of their members is hiding among you guys. That's why you guys gotta find that traitor and kill them dead.
Hey, you better stop.
Shut up, Monami. Big brother defying trash like you needs to be punished.
No.
No, don't pull my ears. They're gonna come off. Monokuma and Monami departed from the area, leaving the rest of us dazed and confused. What was that just now?
What's going on?
Is there anybody who understood what he was talking about? Not a clue.
Hey.
For now, since the sun is setting, we should just go home for the day. I think it's a waste of time for us to keep thinking about this. You're probably right.
Hey.
But it's getting dark soon, so going home might be a better idea. Let's just call it a day. Yay, Monokuma Theater!
I don't like this.
My least favorite food is definitely crab. I also don't like shrimp, apples, tomatoes, and seasoned trout eggs. I don't like red foods at all. Red foods are red because they have crab inside of them. It's actually a conspiracy by the crab industry to try to make me overcome my disgust. There's no way I'd fall for that. I will never ever eat red foods. You see, our society is filled with various hidden conspiracies that are closer than you might think.
Please look forward to
make sure you guys be careful too!
That is honestly, like, way too fucking relevant. Thank you, Monokuma, for that. I'm on the borderline of developing a relationship with a human, you say? Ha! You make me laugh. I'm the supreme overlord of ice. Everything about me is different from humans. My thought process, my principles, my existence, my foundation. Everything. Let's hang out. You want to get closer to me? Such a meaningless act. You should already be aware of it. The fear you feel toward my existence... toward an existence you can't possibly understand. We continued talking as if we were on two separate wavelengths until it was time to leave. Sure, let's see what I can potentially give him. I mean, he might like it.
Fine.
Oh, he totally did. Well, I must say you passed, but only barely.
Be happy!
Fine, in exchange for this item, I shall let you live a little while longer. Okay. That was an experience. Oh, I'm definitely missing some. What the heck? Where even are they? It's still bright out. It's not like I feel like staying here and doing nothing. Maybe I should try going somewhere. Yeah, I'm definitely missing some. Okay. We gotta go on the hunt for those things. It is the Yeah! This is from the first game. Gold-coated sheath. A bamboo sword sheath with a beautiful gold finish on the part where the blade is inserted.
What is it? Do you need me? What should I do? Let's hang out.
I don't mind.
Sure, I don't mind. However, I don't know if I'll have anything interesting to say. I spent time today discussing various things with Pekko. I think Pekko and I grew a little closer. I will try giving her a present. I'm not sure how successful I'll be with it. I'm thinking that sheath. I want to see what she says.
What?
Oh, she does like it. What? You're giving this to me? Hajime, you... I will never forget this favor for the rest of my life.
Hey.
You mentioned earlier that you don't know how... You don't know much about swords, right? Yeah, I've never held a bamboo sword before.
However...
People cannot be judged by their appearances. So you've held an actual sword, just not a bamboo sword. Of course not. I've only ever held toy swords, not bamboo or real swords.
I see.
So you're saying you have no use for a sword. Then are you a striker? Or maybe you're a grappler?
No.
No, perhaps you are well-versed in firearms. Wait, hold on. What are you talking about? Let me explain it more clearly. I completely suck at all those things. I'm not saying I have poor reflexes, but I already know I'm not the warrior type. I see. Given your strangely perceptive way of seeing things, I assumed that you were, but...
However...
Just as you said, you do not have the presence of a warrior. Even if you lost your actual memories, you would not easily lose your muscle memory.
Basically.
Which means you are not suited for battle in the slightest. Thanks. That gives me such great confidence. Pekko gave me a terse stare, and I couldn't help feeling a tingle run up my spine. Is she trying to figure out my talent? Does she want to know what it is just in case I pose a threat? I don't intend to fight my friends at all. I definitely don't want to do that.
Understood.
I see. If that's the case, then we must be extremely cautious of those two.
Anyway.
They know the difference between weakness and strength, and they can compensate for each other's weaknesses. And they both have impressive offensive capabilities. If those two formed an alliance, they could truly pose an unmanageable threat. The dangerous alliance Pekko is talking about, she's probably talking about them. I would say Akane and Nekomaru. A dangerous alliance. Are you talking about Akane and Nekomaru?
Yes.
Though they would fight in self-defense, they are both perfectly at ease doing it. Plus, the combination of an impressive athlete and team manager poses a formidable threat. Not just that, though they do not specialize as fighters, their fighting prowess is incredibly high. However, if something were to happen... Hold on, what are you talking about? It's pretty weird that you're assuming we'd ever need to fight them in the first place. We'll get out of this place if we cooperate with each other. Why do we need to think about fighting anyone? Hajime, you speak the truth. I too would prefer to avoid any senseless killing.
However,
there are times when swords must be drawn, whether you want that or not. What does that mean? Every human being has a duty to fulfill their destiny. That will never change, and there is no need for it to ever change.
Hey.
However, I do not dislike your way of thinking, Hajime. Huh? Hey, Pekko! But even though I called for her, Pekko walked away without looking back at me once. I thought I was understanding Pekko, but now I feel like I don't know her at all. Yay! Hope fragment! I should go back to my room for now. You're still a snake. Oh, your despair meter! Why is it so high? Oh, no! Hold on! Presents! Twilight Syndrome Murder Case?
The name of the game is Twilight Syndrome Murder Case!
What the heck? That's pretty lame. I want to play games about riddle-solving professors or collecting cute monsters.
Stupid! Don't say such silly things! What if we get weighed down by all the quarters?
You can't! You gotta say no! It's a trap!
Hey!
Hey, if that's the motive, won't it be okay if we just don't play it? That's obvious. That's absolutely right. You're quite the genius.
What?
I see. That never occurred to me.
Are you sure you want to do that? Hey!
Learning the motive means you're gonna be prepared, you know. Humans who are prepared and humans who aren't. I don't have to tell you which is strong and which is weak, right?
You.
What do you mean?
For example, if someone secretly played it, that person might come and kill you.
Watch out!
In the context of a preemptive strike, that's truly fatal!
I have never played that one, but I think there's an aspect of either this game or the third one that takes inspiration from that a little bit. I just can't remember if it's this one or the third one. What do you mean?
You guys are all enemies, you know? Is it really all right for your enemy to have an advantage? If you're going to just ignore it, then do whatever you like, even if you're fully aware of the situation.
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
What the heck?
This is bad.
Hey, what should we do?
But...
even if you ask me, there's no way I'll know.
Anyway.
Anyway, it would be dangerous to carelessly touch this game. There is no mistaking that.
You are right.
You are right. It may be better if we wait and see how this plays out.
But
wouldn't it be bad if someone secretly played the game while we're waiting? Whoever gets the motive could be... whoever gets the motive would become the hunter, and the rest of us would be the prey. That's a messed up way to think about it.
What are you saying?
But it's true. Heh, it's your loss if you end up dying. All we need to do is kill if we want to win. I don't want to end up like Byakuya or Teruteru. After Fuyuhiko spat those words, we watched him turn and walk away. But Fuyuhiko makes a good point.
Huh?
You too? What are you saying? Do you really want to kill someone that badly?
Cause...
it's not like that. I mean, how can you be cautious if you don't even know the motive?
Hmm...
That might be true, but...
nope.
It doesn't matter. Huh? Motive or otherwise, it doesn't matter. I won't let another killing happen.
Killing.
I will never,
never allow it.
Let another killer... bleh, bleh. I will never, ever let another killing happen. I'm not gonna spoil it. I won't tell you. We'll just see if it shows up. And if... cause, like, either way, I'm playing through the whole series. So we'll see it eventually. Oh, yay! Another Monokuma Theater!
This is
dropping. You don't know how tough it is to be so successful! I'm so jealous of people who aren't successful and don't have anything. The biggest obstacle to challenging new things is definitely your past successes. Those always hold me back all the time! I'm so jealous of people who don't have anything. People with no expectations sure are happy. I mean, they can do anything they want without worrying about anything!
That's all from
Man, being
theater.
Successful is tough.
I don't know how I feel about that statement coming from him. I don't even get my breakfast first. I just get fucking chore duty right off the bat. Like, what the hell? Man, it's so unlike me to sleep in. Oh, what's with that tray? Are you gonna eat somewhere with a nice view?
Hey,
don't tell me. You're not gonna have a picnic lunch with Miss Sonia, are you? It's not even lunchtime. This is breakfast for Nagito.
No.
Oh, I see. Sorry to trouble you with taking care of him. If you really mean that, want to switch with me?
Hmm.
Well, that's obviously a little awkward. I'll let you handle it, Hajime. He totally ran away. Well. You
can't!
Thanks.
Oh, no. This old building is being renovated. You can't go inside.
If I'm not allowed inside, why is Nagato inside?
You know about it too, Hajime?
Cause Nakamaru and Kazuichi earnestly told me that Monami's the only one we can rely on.
And it's true that Nagato needs to reflect on his actions.
I came here to deliver food to Nagato. It counts as murder if he ends up starving to death, right?
Starve?
It's okay to go inside then.
Yes, make sure you tell him to chew thoroughly before he swallows.
Okay then. Jeez. As I quietly peeked through the door, I saw him on the other side. He was waiting for me with a big smile on his face. Jesus!
Hajime? Could it be... did you take time out of your busy day to bring some food to little old me? Wow, I'm so happy! As you can see, I can't exactly greet you with my full hospitality, but feel free to relax.
Okay. He was the same as usual. Unlike his smile, his words carried a certain heaviness, as if a black poison was falling from his mouth every time he spoke, filling his surroundings with darkness. An illusion, but one I couldn't help feeling at that moment.
Huh? What happened? Your face looks kinda scary.
I didn't come here to talk to you. I just came to bring you something. So come on, eat it.
You're not going to feed me.
What do you mean?
Well, I can't eat it on my own. You know, Since my hands are all tied up, actually, I was really embarrassed to ask a girl to feed me.
Oh, God.
So I'm glad you're the one who came.
Oh, I get it. Friggin' Mahiru. That must be why she asked me to go instead of her.
Anyway, what happened to Mahiru? Did she leave saying she had some business to take care of?
Huh? Why do you know that?
By the way, I heard about Twilight Syndrome murder case, was it? I have mixed feelings. I really like that game a lot.
What? Who's been feeding you information?
Don't change the subject. I'm asking you.
Oh, well. I'm a little disappointed. It's not like you Ultimates to ignore the threat that's standing right in front of you. So are you really planning not to play the game? Do you think Monokuma will just let that slide? Well, that is, you guys should confront it. After all, hope springs when you confront despair.
Kyomo sounds reasonable. Running away from your problems isn't a solution. I'm just putting it off, but...
I don't want to be tricked by you anymore. Bye now.
Hey, Hajime! Weren't you planning to feed me? Hey! Hajime!
I probably just, like, left the food on the ground and just wandered off. I feel like that's exactly what happened.
However,
I don't understand why that game is the motive at all. However,
no.
This isn't good. It might be good if I do some training to calm myself down. I will hang out with her. I'm going to train, but watching me would be boring. Would you like to try too? I'll teach you how to properly grip a bamboo sword. Oh, sweet! That's actually cool. I spent time today learning how to wield a bamboo sword from Pekko. I think Pekko and I grew a little closer. I'll try and give her a present. I've got a few things. Maybe the bandages.
I see.
Oh, look at that. Hmm, what an interesting item. Thank you, Hajime. I shall use it well. It feels like she's making an even more intense face than usual. Is she worried about something? I can't tell if I should ask or not. Hey, are you alright? You're starting to turn pale.
What?
Was I? What? What were you even trying to do?
No.
Well, actually, I was trying to smile. Huh? Mahiru told me that I'm the only one who doesn't smile for her pictures. So I thought I should do something about it, but it's harder than I thought.
Hey.
So, will you try to make me laugh? This is sudden. Anything is fine as long as it's funny, so give it a try. You're acting like you lowered the bar, but it's still really high.
Yippee.
I know. If it's possible, I'd like it to have something to do with animals. That might be something that stirs warm feelings inside me. That may be, but, then... Panda. Panda walks into a restaurant, eats, shoots, and leaves.
Yes.
I already know they do that. Crap, I botched the delivery, and it's not even that clever of a joke. However, pandas are nice. Their white and black fur is very adorable and fluffy. Someday I would like to try to touch one. Pekko's face seemed to soften a little when she said that. Even though my joke completely failed to land, well, I guess this'll do.
I apologize.
You help me, Hajime. I can't really smile that well. I've been like this ever since I was young. The childhood friend I always played with used to cry and say my face was scary. There was also a time when my first love coldly told me that, too. Even so, I never really needed to smile, so I never thought about it all that much. And because I completely neglected it, I forgot how to do it entirely. It's not normal for someone to forget how to smile. Was she subjected to an outrageous amount of harsh training, or is there some other reason?
Hey,
Hajime, what's wrong? Nothing. Anyway, I'll make sure to tell you a funnier joke next time. That would be wonderful. I'll be looking forward to it. I kept chatting with Pekko for a while and spent time thinking of ideas for funny jokes. Yay! The report card is updated. There you are.
Let me ask.
What is it, Jumpy? Are you interested in this lowly creature? No, he's not someone that the four Dark Divas of Destruction need to worry about. What should I do? Can I even hang out with someone like him? Yes, we're gonna be best friends. Don't misunderstand, Jumpy and I still haven't acknowledged you yet. I spent time with Gundam and his four Dark Divas of Destruction today. Looks like Gundam and I grew closer. Yes. I want to give him the sunflower seeds. There they are.
You
Hajime, you fiend. You are rather nice. As long as this treasure is within my grasp, I will never forget this day.
I can see it!
Don't get any closer. I already know what you're thinking. What do you know that even I don't know?
So you have
now then, summon your familiar. No, I don't have anything like that.
You fiend.
You've come challenging me many times. I thought you finally obtained at least one familiar. Just as I thought, you were just a mere human, and a strange one at that. Despite what he's saying, Gundam doesn't seem all that annoyed. Is he opening up to me a little? However, you probably don't understand how pointless this place is for a demon beast tamer. Now that you mention it, even though this is a tropical island, I don't really see any wild animals.
Fine.
If this place really was a normal tropical island, I wouldn't have time to talk to you so freely. Many beasts inhabit the thick forests. There may even be rare species that only exist in this island. Just thinking about it makes me tingle. Wow, he's smiling right now. Ah, I see. That was weird. There we go. Oh, I seem to recall seeing a cow at the ranch. I'm not interested in some domesticated animal. I had a feeling you'd say that. After all, I cannot look at it without feeling pity. Huh? That's a bit unexpected. Such creatures are born to be eaten by humans. Even if I had the all-seeing eye, I couldn't change that fate. Thus, I try not to involve myself with livestock. It would bring a calamity onto my mind after all. Gundam understands the feelings of animals, so this must be a complicated subject for him.
This body is uncool.
I appear to be getting oddly sentimental since I haven't encountered any new demon beasts. I've tamed various creatures such as the Cerberus, the Phoenix, and even the Midgard Serpent. He probably means dogs, birds, and lizards. When you say tamed, what exactly does that entail? I guess it's fine to tell him you're human. I don't believe that you'll get in my way.
Listen,
basically,
well.
You must say, good girl, good girl. Huh? You must repeatedly speak to them and make sure they understand that there is no ill will on our end. In order to do that, you need to appear innocent. Of course, there are some who like to be touched and some that don't. It's better if you keep these basics down.
It appears.
Afterward, as long as you spend a long time together, you'll eventually start to hear your partner's words. I'm pretty sure that only happens to ultimate breeders. But Gundam seems different from usual when he talks about animals. Somehow, his face seems gentler. He must really love animals.
Fine.
Now then, I wonder if there are evil demon beasts that will rile me up on this island somewhere. Monokuma and Monomi are sort of shaped like animals.
I renounce you!
They are no good. Anything that can talk will eventually betray you. Fuck, he's not wrong. That is... yeah. Damn. And most importantly, they aren't cute. I agree. But I don't plan to betray you at all. Such exaggerations coming from a mere human like you. However, that's a nice line. Gundam left the area with a different smile on his face than usual. Oh, with a baseball bat. Down 5. Okay. Huh? Is this the end? Wait, now it's game over for some reason. I don't get it. Even the game's structure doesn't make sense. It started with the second day all of a sudden and jumped to the fourth day afterward. Why were the first day and third day skipped? And what's with this down 5 message on the game over screen? Down 5? Who's down by 5? What the heck is this? I don't get this at all. How would this be the motive? Is this what it's like to play a crappy game? For now, it's a waste of time to just stay here, so I should go back to my cottage and think about it. But I didn't get an envelope. I just played the game and that's it. Why did Fuyuhiko have an envelope? Oh, Monokuma Theater again!
Hey!
Life isn't just about moving forward. When confronted by an important question, it's good to stop moving and take your time thinking about it. For example, my stomach hasn't felt well all morning, so I ran to the restroom as soon as I got off the train. But right when I was about to enter, an important question stood before me. Life is like that every now and then. Suddenly, an important question gets in your way. The important question that stood before me was the gentleman's sign on the restroom door. As I resisted the overwhelming urge to poop, I thought about it desperately. Am I really a gentleman? Do I have class? Am I honest? Am I faithful? No, why am I even hesitating? Of course I'm a gentleman. A regular person wouldn't last 5 minutes resisting this urge to poop, but a gentleman most certainly would. Filled with pride, I ran into the restroom meant for gentlemen, and what awaited me was... another important question. The important question that stood before me was the Western-style and Japanese-style signs on each door. I was definitely born in Japan, but haven't I forgotten what makes clean, beautiful Japan so good? Do I have enough confidence in myself to take a Japanese-style poop? As you can see, there are always important questions waiting for you.
Brought to you by Monokuma!
That's what life is all about!